In 2002, I was a one-man band, charging $10 an hour with a small startup I called Vertical Horizons. Not a bad start, considering I was a 14-year-old sophomore in high school. I didn't have my driver's license yet, so one of the prerequisites of hiring me was that you had to come pick me up. That was kind of inconvenient, but it's not like I had a ton of clients. Mostly, I was helping seniors set up printers and learn how to use their email. In 2003, I took a big step. I brought on a partner, opened up a storefront, and filed to become a legal corporation, Vertical Horizons Computer Services, Inc. And I immediately began working 3 extra jobs to pay for all the added expenses. Fortunately, one of those jobs was at Staples, where I was able to secure great deals on equipment and access a steady stream of new clients. In 2005, it was time to grow. I found a new business partner, purchased a building on Route 9 in Hadley, and merged my 1,000 residential customers with another company, transforming Vertical Horizons into Valley Computer Works, providing both residential and commercial IT support. It wasn't a great start. We took on a lot of debt, and the relationship between me and my new business partner fell apart. I wasn't ready to quit, though, so I doubled down, borrowing $500 from a friend and using that to borrow $5,000 from an acquaintance. Then I used that to borrow $100,000 from a bank. I bought out my business partner and began focusing 100% of my time and energy on growing Valley Computer Works. Over the next few years, all my hard work was starting to pay off. The company was growing, I was able to hire some employees, we landed a huge commercial account, and we purchased our very first Mini Cooper. By 2008, things were really starting to come together. We had about 3,000 residential customers, 8 commercial clients, and great staff. This was also the beginning of our award-winning streak. Excited by our growth, we decided to take a bold move. We hired away the general manager of our largest competitor and, having just met Darby O'Brien, decided to make sure everyone in the area knew that we did it. Coincidentally, it was also the year of our first lawsuit. In 2010, after hiring a full-time salesperson, we launched a new division called EMRConference.com, an events company that put on conferences for doctors thinking about purchasing an EMR. It was also around this time that we decided we needed a new name. Valley Computer Works felt small and boring. We wanted something big and exciting. After months of brainstorming and a lot of bad ideas, finally the Paragus brand and the baby were born. We also made another bold move and decided to shut down our residential practice, writing off a significant portion of our income to focus exclusively on serving small local businesses. With a new name and a new direction to share with our staff, we decided it was time for a party. We booked the World War II Club in Northampton and did the big reveal. It was only the beginning, but it was a promising beginning. After shutting down our residential division in March of 2011, we still managed to almost double our annual revenue, and we gave birth to the idea of the annual fall retreat. Over the next couple years, Paragus went from a word that no one had ever heard of to the leading IT firm in the region, with a wide roster of business clients and the best tech talent in the area on our team. Our customized Mini Coopers became recognizable all over the valley. We worked hard to provide our clients with small business service and big company resources. We also had a lot of fun. We formed our own dodgeball team and cultivated an employee garden. We continued to build on the annual fall retreat and added a spring retreat. In 2012, Paragus was ranked on Inc. magazine's list of the 5,000 fastest growing businesses in the country. We were growing so fast that we had to add a satellite office in a backyard trailer just to accommodate it. We also got more involved in the community. That year, Paragus was featured as an underwriter of Valley Gives Day, an event that raised a lot of money for local nonprofits. It was also the first year we sponsored Business West's annual 40 Under 40 event. In 2013, we made 2 very significant announcements. First, we announced that we had reached a deal to build our dream building just down the road from our existing office. Second, at our fall retreat, after spending 2 days learning all about business and hosting our very own mock Shark Tank, I announced that Paragus had plans to become an employee-owned company. It was also in 2013 that Paragus helped to found Tech Foundry, a nonprofit dedicated to helping bridge the gap between underrepresented communities in the IT space and the employers who, like us, were struggling to find the talent they needed to keep up with their growth. With partners like MassMutual, UMass, and Bay State Health, Tech Foundry raised nearly $450,000 in less than 3 months, built out the 9th floor of a downtown Springfield office building, and quickly became an important part of the IT workforce community. With everything that was going on, we continued to experience record growth, 546% over 6 years. Not bad. And rack up some more awards. And last but not least, 2013 was the year that we introduced our famous Morgan Freeman voicemail message.
Hello, and thank you for calling Paragus Strategic IT.
In 2014, we had to pick up stakes and move to a temporary office in downtown Springfield while our new headquarters was being built. For the first time in 3 years, all of our staff were once again under one roof, and it afforded us the opportunity to expand our brand, get to know a lot of great people, and play a huge role in the official launch of Tech Foundry, which was conveniently just 7 floors above us. It also gave us a chance to pull off our first big public event. The Winter Olympics were held that year, and it seemed like everyone was obsessed with curling. Darby's group thought a fun way to introduce ourselves to the local business community would be to hold a curling event at the MassMutual Center. At first, we dismissed the idea as being logistically impossible and way too expensive. But Darby's team somehow managed to get it done, and despite just one injury, it was an awesome event. Encouraged by the success of our curling event, we continued to push the envelope with our marketing. At Business West 40 Under 40 event that we sponsored later that year, we introduced one of the most beloved and controversial characters in history of Paragus, William Joseph Bushy.
And God bless Paragus like thee.
Meanwhile, Tech Foundry was also off to a credible start. With some help from Paragus, Tech Foundry raised $90,000 in just 24 hours during Valley Gives Day, the highest amount ever raised by a first-time participant. To be able to generate that much support for a cause that we cared so much about was a very proud moment for all of us. However, the icing on the cake was moving into our brand new facility on October 4th, followed by a truly kick-ass open house where over 300 people came and consumed over 150 pounds of delicious barbecue. When 2015 started, we were all living on cloud nine. We had moved into our brand new office, we were launching our own private data center, and we were continuing to stay in the media's limelight. That year, Tech Foundry was visited by the two famous Steves in the tech world, Apple co-founder Steve Wozniak and Steve Vinter, director of Google Cambridge, both toured the facility and met with the students, further driving home the message to the students that anything is possible. The star power continued at the Business West 40 Under 40 event where, without telling anyone, we brought in wrestling legend Nature Boy Ric Flair to be a surprise master of ceremonies. It was a huge gamble, but he didn't disappoint. The night was an overwhelming success that further elevated our brand. The event was such a big deal that Bushy even rented a tux for the occasion. Amongst all the good news and accolades, we discovered something very important. We solved the space and staffing issues, but realized that our current business model was not going to continue to scale. In other words, if we were going to keep growing, we needed to make some big changes. So we made two important decisions. First, we were going to implement EOS at Paragus. Second, the Friday before our fall retreat, I met with our leadership team and asked them to imagine that we were building the perfect MSP from scratch, not encumbered by any of our existing structure. The result, our three pillars of IT concept was born. All that being said, we continued to grow and increase our sales, and the awards kept coming in. Overall, 2015 was a very good year. In many ways, the Paragus that exists today started in 2016. We pretty much rebuilt the entire company from scratch. Every existing position was eliminated, and every partner was interviewed for a new role as we built out the departments and positions that exist today. Our refined core values were rolled out, and many of the other aspects of our EOS VTO were presented for the very first time. We also created a brand new leadership team to run the day-to-day operations of the company. With all of these exciting announcements to share, Paragus once again booked the World War II Club in Northampton and had another major unveiling. To make room for the new leadership team to spread their wings, I took my family down to Costa Rica for 7 weeks. I was the first partner to take advantage of the 6-week paid sabbatical program that was described in Vision 2020, which coincidentally was also the first time I was ever away from Paragus for more than 5 days. This man was left behind to take my place. He even hosted the 40 Under 40 Awards that year. While I was away, I made one of the most important and exciting announcements in the history of Paragus. After 2.5 years of learning, spending, meetings, planning, and negotiating, On June 8th of 2016, I sent an email to our staff announcing that Paragus was officially an employee-owned company. It was in this email that for the very first time, I referred to our staff as partners. It was also the year of some epic April Fool's shenanigans. By November of that year, it became clear that we lacked the systems, processes, training, and role clarity needed to truly set our partners up for success. And our leadership team, passionate and dedicated as they were, lacked the training and experience needed to navigate such an enormous amount of change. As a result, I returned to Paragus as a one-man leadership team in an effort to get things back on track. However, despite all the transition and chaos, we still continued to grow our top line. Over the next 3 years, we worked harder than we have ever worked before. Having made so many changes in 2016, our focus for the next 2.5 years was to restore order and consistency. We also had some hard work to do in our culture. Somewhere along the way, the transparency and collaborative approach that is so important to Paragus had been lost. Out of this, the weekly address was born. We also needed to make sure that we not only worked hard, but that we played hard. So we rented out a summer camp and created an absolutely epic weekend that was unlike any fall retreat we have ever hosted before. In fact, it was so epic, we repeated it 2 more times. We made some key technological changes as well, migrating from Microsoft Access Database to ConnectWise Manage. We also announced the first draft of the Fair and Equitable Contract, a contract that included many services which incentivized Paragus to become more efficient and replace the previous contract model that had been in place for 12 years. And we unveiled our Wall of Fame to honor our former partners and the significant contributions they made to getting us where we are. 2018 was also a really fun year. We celebrated our competitive spirit with an Office Olympics event featuring such challenges as binder clip diving, speed typing, and paper airplane throwing. We also returned to camp for the second year and celebrated Employee Ownership Month by having an employee potluck that featured staff creations, which we captured in an employee cookbook. Another random highlight of 2018? In Paragus fashion, we decided to take a running joke on Facebook just a little too far. Or was it just far enough? In 2019, the transition back to a leadership team began. With much support from our board of directors, Paragus began the process of properly training, managing, and coaching Paragus managers into the leaders the company was going to need to be able to continue to grow. 2019 was also certainly not light on fun. With a return trip to camp, a kick-ass recycling drive for Earth Day, our biggest end-of-year celebration ever, a visit from the governor, and an article that we wrote on CNBC received over 1 million views. All with plenty of office antics to help make IT fun along the way. And even though our focus was largely on our internal systems, we still managed to put up some sweet numbers. Most people, when they think of 2020, can only remember the pandemic. However, for Paragus, 2020 was one of the best years in our history. After 3 very hard years of really working on our business, and as a result, sacrificing profits and growth, in 2020, all that hard work and all those investments really started paying off. And while the pandemic did hurt our revenue, our new leadership team was up to the challenge and did such a good job of managing the crisis that we came out of the pandemic even stronger than we went into it. 2020 was also the year that for the first time since 2010, we began building a sales and marketing department and consistently running campaigns throughout the year that were being thoroughly followed up on and that were producing real results. It also wasn't long after the year started that we got some incredibly exciting news. Paragus had been selected for the most prestigious award we had ever received. We had been chosen as one of Forbes magazine's 25 small giants. And while the pandemic did put a damper on Paragus Day as it was originally envisioned and caused the cancellation of our spring and fall retreat, we still managed to have some great parties and make IT fun for our clients and our partners. As we look back at the last 18 years, it is absolutely stunning to think about how far we have come. I could never have imagined that side gig I had in high school would have ever become the company we all love today. And while a lot has changed over those 18 years, there are also a lot that hasn't. The values, the culture, and the purpose that fueled our growth and success in the beginning is in so many ways the same values, culture, and purpose that define who we are today. However, True to our core value of getting better, the real question is what's next? If you ask me, we're just getting started.